Hi, welcome to PMP Resource Management webinar session from Edureka. I am CMR Chandra MR, a certified project management professional. So as part of resource management knowledge area, we are going to look at understanding what is project resource management knowledge area is all about, resource management overview, and resource management processes. So now before we get started, subscribe to Edureka YouTube channel and hit the bell icon to never miss an update from us on trending technologies. Also, if you are looking for an online training certification in PMP, check out the link in the description given below. So, project resource management. PMP defines 10 knowledge areas. One of the knowledge areas is project resource management. When we say project resource management, we should look at understanding what are the resources required for managing the projects, and then acquiring those resources and managing throughout the project lifecycle. So for this, we need to understand what project resource management is all about. When I say resource, resource can be human resource can be a technology resource can be any resource which is required for a project to be done. Now, when we say scope, for example, you will define a scope for a deliverable, which will come as an output of a project. Similarly, while defining the project, we should also define the scope of those resources which are required to deliver that result. So, project resource management includes the processes to identify, acquire, and manage the resources needed for the successful completion of the project. So, resource management overview. This includes the trends and emerging practices. When I say resource management methods, so we know the dynamics associated with various different resources. So we acquire the resources based on what kind of project we are doing. In common, the kind of resources, human resources, we will have in every projects. For example, if you say IT project, you need human resource. If you say civil construction project, you need resource. But the dynamics with this human resources changes based on the what kind of skills and capability and experiences that resource will have in a given project. Similarly, when it's IT project, you need to work on applications, you need to work on network devices, infrastructure components. But when it's a civil constructions, you're all not working with those IT components. Instead, we're speaking about cement, brick, sand, etc. So even quantifying those resources and acquiring those resources and utilizing those resources in a given project is very essential. So dynamics of those resources has to be understood, and accordingly, it has to be handled. So in specific, when we say human resources, emotional intelligence plays a very important role for project manager to have to use during the project management. So this requires an effort from a project manager to pretend certain roles. For example, when we say leadership, we speak about authoritarian leadership, laissez-faire leadership, participative leadership. So when to be authoritarian, when should you behave authoritative, when should a project manager be participative, when should the project manager should become laissez-faire, means delegate and allow team to work on it and then review it. So this requires a lot of influencing thoughts while engaging with the people, especially the project team members, what we're speaking about, while engaging with the customers, while engaging with suppliers, while engaging with sponsors. These transactions need certain emotional influence as well, for which emotional intelligence may be required. So self-organizing team as a buzzword which comes across whenever we speak about agile mostly. But however, today with the changing needs of the business, where the quick response is required to go to market, at the same time when we go to market quickly, the operations needs to respond to it, manage it the way the user wants it. User may have queries. Ultimately, the experience of the users makes sense. Only then value realization happens. So because of that, enablement across the organization, right from the teams who are in the project as well as who are managing that particular product or services, is required. For that, many organizations have thought about self-organizing team, where the team is owning that product or services in entirety rather than one individual or one specific specialist owning it. Then with the advancement of technology, today movement of skills who are distributed across various different regions may not be needed. So there may be virtual teams, distributed teams who will work together with the help of the technologies. This also comes up with a lot of challenges because teams are not in front of the project manager always. So this requires a specific approach towards managing those resources, which the project manager should understand and deal with. So tailoring considerations while doing resource management is to mainly understand the diversity of resources, as I mentioned, based on the various different capabilities, various different geographical locations, The physical location is another consideration. So because culture changes, people come from different backgrounds. Then industry-specific resources, project-specific, industry-specific. So as per the industry, as per the projects, again, the thought processes, the dynamics associated with the resources will change. The management requirement of the resources itself will differ. Acquisition of team members. So when you actually start a project, when execution starts, you may require to ramp up the team members. So identification of the right skills and capabilities. Before that, one has to define the clearly articulating roles and responsibilities in the project organization structure. And accordingly, team members has to be acquired. So interestingly, you cannot get a resource, especially human resource, who are tailor-made to the project. So they need to be trained, inducted, educated about the project and make them to become ready for the project execution. So as the project progresses, managing this team, engaging with this team and making things delivered in time as defined in schedule within the cost needs to be ensured by engaging with the team. So life cycle approaches, as I already mentioned, a product will have a life cycle. Similarly, project itself will have a life cycle. So when I say product life cycle is bigger than a project life cycle. So we use a project to introduce a product. We initiate a project to bring in new features, functionality to the existing product. We initiate a project to improve something. We initiate a project to retire a specific product or services. So we need to visualize that life cycle of a product. At the same time, what would be the life cycle of this project, which is going to introduce something to that environment? So in a way, project itself is a big change management because it introduces the change to the environment. So project itself will have a life cycle. When we say that, a beginning and end, temporary end over, that's what PMP says. It has a specific start, specific end. From this start to end, there is a life cycle for project, which is part of an entirety of a product life cycle or service life cycle. So according to what kind of products are we creating, what kind of projects we have taken, is that improvement project or creation of new product or services, or to introduce the features and functionality to the existing product or services, or to retire a product or services, depending on that which life cycle of this specific product or services, projects are initiated and accordingly it has to be dealt with. So resource management processes. So resource management processes are distributed across various process groups. When I say plan resource management, estimate activity resources, they fall under planning process group. Acquire resources, develop team and manage team are part of executing process group. And control resources is a process which is part of managing and control process group. So plan resource management, the first process in planning process group in resource management knowledge area. So plan resource management is the first and the initial step of the project resource management knowledge area. While planning for resources, one needs to understand what kind of resources are required and how are we going to engage. If it is a human resource, engage and manage. If it is not a human resource, any other resources, how are we going to manage? Technology resources or the facilities, resources in the facilities. So this involves various aspects like defining the process of estimating, acquiring, managing, and using physical and human resources. So this process is usually performed only once or at few predefined points throughout the project lifecycle to help in establishing the way of approach and level of management required for managing resources. So every resource needs to be assessed, understood. What kind of resources is required and how are we going to manage this has to be clearly articulated to manage it as the project progresses. So these aspects are majorly influenced by the type and complexity of the project. So inputs to this process would be project charter, project management plan, project documents. When I say project charter, we know that project charter is created in initiating process group, so which provides the basic details. And that comes as an input to planning process group. One of that process where project charter is coming as an input is plan resource management. Project management plan, which basically quality management plan, scope baselines, which comes from integration management, and then project documents like project schedule, requirements documentations, risk registers, stakeholder registers, and further input can be enterprise environmental factors and organizational processes assets. The tools used as part of planned resource management is expert judgment, data representation, organizational theory, and meetings. When we say experts, all those specialized people who are having the specific experience in terms of managing resources. a specific resource and various different data considerations. And since we are speaking about resource management, we should also look at what kind of organization structure required for this project. And there should be meetings, engaging with the people, discussion should happen. Outputs of plan resource management are resource management plan, then team charter, and then project documents updates. When I say resource management plan, we are going to understand from it what are the approaches we have to manage the resources and what kind of team structure we would have. So what dynamics are involved with it. So this particular plan will go and get consolidated into plan which is integrated in integration management. This is one of the subsidiary plans. So process, estimate, activity resources. So when I say estimate activity resources, the details of activities are already captured in schedule management. So when we say scope management, for example, so scope management provides scope baseline. While deriving that scope baseline, work breakdown structure is created. As part of it, further you will identify an effort, activities for those WBS elements. And this happens in schedule management. So referring to that schedule management for the WBS element for which efforts are estimated, here you need to look at what kind of resource and in what quantity is required. So estimate activity resources will be doing the planning of estimating the activity resources based on the WBS structure defined. So in this process, the resource required for the project along with the type and quantity of tools, equipments, raw materials and supplies are being estimated. This process is generally executed after specific time intervals throughout the project lifecycle. With this, one can pinpoint that what type of resources project needs and in what amounts, means quantity, and what should be their characteristics in order to finish the project successfully. So estimate activity resources, this can be done only after creation of WBS structure. And also schedule management sequences, which activity has to be done after what. So because of this sequencing, while estimating the resources, one should also be able to know when is this resources required. Not just what resource at what quantity and also when, because of the schedule management which is working parallel to resource management. Inputs to this process: project management plan, which includes resource management plan and scope baseline, then project documents, which involves activity attributes, activity list, assumptions log, cost estimates, resource calendars, risk register, enterprise environmental factors, resource locations, resource availability, because we should know what is available resource in the organization so that they can be allocated to the project. So team resource skills, organization culture, published estimating data, marketplace conditions, organization process assets, which includes policies and procedures and historical informations. So the tools used as part of estimate activity resources are expert judgment, data representation, organization theory, and meetings. Outputs. So outputs includes resource requirements, basis of estimates, resource breakdown structure, and project document updates. So resource requirements against the activity which needs to be done. And there should be an explanation why so much of resource is estimated. That is basis of estimation. Resource breakdown structure provides the details relating to the WBS structure what we have. How the resources are connected, how the resources are related, because we need also link it to organization structure. So acquire resources, this is the process which happens in executing process group. So this process deals with collecting the various human resources, facilities, tools, equipments, supplies and raw materials required to deliver the project. So human resources are identified and onboarded. Facilities, tools, equipments and supplies are procured, which are required to be used in the project. So this process helps in outlining and guiding the selection process of the project resources and then assigning them to their specific activities or tasks. Thus, it is performed at periodic intervals throughout the project lifecycle and helps in preventing running out of resources. So appropriate number of resources has quantified in estimating resources. So inputs: project management plan, which includes resource management plan, procurement management plan, cost baseline. Project document like project schedule, resource calendars, resource requirements, stakeholder registers, enterprise environmental factors, which is existing information on organizational resources, marketplace conditions, organization structure, Then geographical locations, where exactly one needs the resources, where is that resource available. OPAs, organization process asset, which includes policies and procedures, historical informations, and lessons learned repository. Tools would be decision making, interpersonal and team skills, pre-assignment, and virtual teams. When I say decision making, so one needs to finalize which resource with what features and functionality. Those needs to be identified before you acquire and confirm. Interpersonal and team skills, because there needs certain discussions, certain engagement required when you procure or when you onboard a human resource. Pre-assignment, maybe the one in the team, in the organization with the specific skills, which are matching with the organizational or project required skills. So assigning those resources. Virtual teams, if teams are spread across various different locations. So output of this process would be physical resource assignment, means the resources are acquired, they are onboarded. Project team assignments, you have a team to work now, so the team is assigned, the members are assigned to the given role. Resource calendars, specifying where exactly the resources are available. Change requests, if any change required in the structure or the kind of resources. Then project management plan updates, project document updates, EF updates, and then OPA updates. Develop team process. So as you acquire a human resources, you may require to educate them in terms of what is that expected out of them in a given project and what is their role. An individual may have a specific skills and capability. That's okay. That's about specific skills and capability. But what is expected out of that particular individual with that specific skills and capability in this project? What is the deliverable from that individual? So this process purely concentrates on the development of team bonding and assigning them with rewarding work, future opportunities, and career development. So someone working in a project, if that is not contributing to their further future career progression, they may not be very motivated because of that. So one needs to give that visibility as well as the member to the project is onboarded. This will help in enhancing the overall team performance by improving team members' competencies, interactions, and the environment. So this process is performed throughout the project lifecycle and intensifies teamwork, improves interpersonal skills of the individuals, motivates the team, and reduces attritions. So this requires providing a lot of insights toward the project, what is that they are going to deliver, and how that will contribute to their progression in their career a positive way. So these visibility should be there. So this requires an induction. When team is onboarded, there is brainstorming which happens. Maybe team members may not know each other. So one has to ensure a facilitation has to be done so that team will know each other so that they can start performing. So inputs, project management plan, which is basically resource management plan, project documents like lessons learned register, project team assignments, resource calendars, team charter, EF, enterprise environmental factors, which is human resource management policies, team member skills, competencies, and specialized knowledge, geographical distribution of team members, whereas OPAs, organizational process assets, that is historical information, and lessons learned repository. The tools used as part of developed team would be co-location, virtual teams, communication technology, interpersonal and team skills, recognition and rewards, training, individual and team assignments, meetings. When we say co-location, people exist in various different locations in the globe, so there needs a lot of interactions. So formal communication should be increased there so that the transaction, the clarity which needs to be provided to the team will be easier and more connects. Even when you work with the team which is sitting next to you, since you are present, that effort to connect may not be required. So because it will be happening naturally. But whereas team doesn't exist in front of the project manager, it requires a lot of effort to connect, to keep that communication channels open always. So virtual teams, I mean similar dynamics as we saw co-locations. So communication technology, using appropriate communication technology to connect with the teams. So interpersonal and team skills, which as we spoke about emotional intelligence, as we spoke about laissez-faire or authoritarian approaches or participative approaches required. So while engaging with the teams, it's very essential. The project manager should possess that leadership traits, leadership qualities to connect with the team and influence them. So recognition and rewards. So recognition and rewards helps to motivate. So this will also help in terms of showing the quick wins happening in the project. So providing the training whenever is required on the specific areas, maybe a soft skills, maybe technology specific, maybe specific skill acquiring. So training has to be given and enable the team. Individual and team assessments, and then meetings. Outputs of developed team process would be team performance assessments, change requests, project management plan updates, project document updates, EEF updates, and OPA updates. Managed team. So managed team is a process where each and every team member performance is monitored and tracked. It is very essential to understand how the individuals are performing, how the resources are performing. Based on that, necessary actions need to be taken to correct if there is any deviations. If things are going fine, there should be a motivation to the team. And also tracking their problem areas, which are identified and the issues are resolved and feedbacks are given on a regular basis. So this process is generally performed throughout the project lifecycle and helps in influencing team behavior, managing the conflicts and resolving brewing issues. Very essential to engage with the team. The team which is just given a task and left may not tend to accomplish the results what is required. They need the directions every now and then. One has to sit and evaluate those performances and give the necessary feedbacks and also platforms for them to acquire those skills and capabilities to perform better. Inputs to this process, project management plan, which is resource management plan, project documents, that is issue log, lessons learned register, project team assessment, team charter, work performance report like physical or electronic representation of work performance information, team performance assessments. The project management team makes ongoing formal or informal assessments of the project team's performance so that one will get that visibility so that accordingly necessary changes can be done. Enterprise environmental factors, which is basically human resource management policies, then organization process assets like certificates of appreciation, corporate apparels and other organizational prerequisites. Tools used as part of this process would be interpersonal and team skills, project management information system. So PMIS, which captures all the details of the project, resources details, deliverables details, skill details, and then the way project is progressing. So these data can be utilized to give that insight to the project team and make them to progress further. Outputs of this process would be change request, procurement management plan updates, project document updates, and EEF updates. Control resources. So control resources is the process in monitoring and control process group. So in this process, the project managers ensures that the resources that are assigned and allocated for the project activities are available as needed. They also monitor their estimated usage versus actual usage. So you quantify the resources when you estimate. These are the number of resources which are required at any given point in time. Because we took that estimating the resources based on what activities are identified and how they are sequenced. So we refer to that scope and schedule. Accordingly, estimation happened. So in actual scenario, is that utilization is happening accordingly or is there any variations, increase or decreased? Subsequently, if any deviations found, necessary corrective actions needs to be taken. For that corrective actions needs to be triggered. So control resource process is implemented throughout the project lifecycle and helps in ensuring that necessary project resources are deployed to the correct places at the correct time and are released when the project comes to an end. So this is about control resources. The inputs to process, project management plan, basically resource management plan, project documents, that is issue log, lessons learned register, physical resource assignments, project schedule, resource breakdown structure, resource requirements, risk register, work performance data, which would contain the data on project status such as number and types of resources that have been used, agreements made within the context of project, which are basis for all resources or external to the organization, OPA, that is policies regarding resource control and assignment, escalation procedures for handling issues within the performing organizations, lessons learned repository from previous similar projects. Tools, data analysis, problem solving, interpersonal skills, PMIS. Outputs of control resource process would be work performance information, change request if any deviations found, procurement management plan updates, and then project document updates. So this concludes resource management knowledge area, basic awareness in terms of what is resource management is all about and what are the various processes involved in resource management knowledge area defined in PMP framework. Thank you so much for being here with us. I hope this video helped you to understand the basics of resource management knowledge area. Take care until we come back to look at next webinar session. Thank you.
I hope you have enjoyed listening to this video. Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries, and we will reply them at the earliest. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to Edureka channel to learn more. Happy learning!